Hello children, today we will learn that how some of the countries that were under the colonial rule freed. The countries that fought for their freedom and embraced democracy. You know what democracy is? You live in a democratic country. Yes, India is a democratic country.
The word democracy literally means ruled by the people. Let us start with Libya. It became free after a long struggle in 1951. Italy transferred power to King Idris, who ruled the country with the help of rich and powerful families. Basically, Libyans belonged to different tribes that depended on agriculture and animal rearing for their living. But then, Libya's fate was about to be changed. Vast petroleum reserves were found in Libya in 1959. These petroleum reserves fetched a huge amount of wealth in Libya. The wealth was controlled by king and powerful families of Libya.
The young people of Libya were not happy with this and they wanted to establish modern state for the welfare of people. People in Libya wanted a change in the way the country was functioning. They wanted to share the profits that the country was getting. So, in 1969, a revolt broke out under the leadership of Muammar Gaddafi against the king. This revolt had the desired results. King Idris fled the country and Gaddafi declared the country as Socialist Libyan Arab Republic. He took control of Libya with the assistance of military. Gaddafi provided all facilities to the people of Libya. As a result, 90% literacy rate was achieved in Libya. However, he did not allow the people to participate in the public affair.
To control the people, revolutionary command councils were appointed. RCC tortured and killed political opponents.
In 2012, movements started against Gaddafi, demanding the establishment of democratic government. In 2011, people finally revolted against the government. Government took all the repressive methods that were required to suppress the movement. Thousands of people were killed.
So, what do you think? Gaddafi was a good ruler or a bad one? He was a dictator who ruled over Libya for 42 years. No doubt, he kept the people of Libya under his strict control. But there was a good side of his rule also. The petrol prices were cheap for the Libyans, electricity was free, newlywed couples were given some money to start their new life.
The people were not content still, because what they wanted was democracy. But there were many negative aspects of Gaddafi. He ruled with an iron fist and controlled the mass media. Media shared only that information with the people which Gaddafi wanted them to hear. Gaddafi encouraged a number of Islamist and communist militant groups in Philippines. He was an eccentric and finicky ruler who spent lavishly on himself. He dispatched tanks and jet fighters to disperse and kill protesters. Hundreds were killed. The exact toll is impossible to know. Due to his eccentricities, the powerful countries of the world, like the United States, were keen to end his rule and establish a government that would be more favorable to them. He was caught and killed by the Libyan rebels in October 2012 when he was trying to flee.
After the death of Gaddafi, a new government was established with free and fair elections. Now, the eyes of the whole world are on Libya to see whether the democracy will be successful in Libya or not.
The Western countries were obviously interested in Libya's petroleum reserves. Who wouldn't be? These days, prices of petrol are touching the sky. Now, let us discuss how Burma got its democratic rights.